One of the advantages of a case enclosure is that most of the construction work can be done elsewhere, especially when you have to work at a given location where only a short working season is possible, like in the Netherlands, where it's difficult to work with floating equipment at sea in winter. This is a big advantage. The caissons can be built in a protected place, also during the stormy periods. In the Netherlands, usually a shallow area is surrounded by a dike. Then the water is pumped out of this area and a construction area is created. Such a building dock is below mean sea level and has to be kept dry using pumps. This is not a problem and is common practice for most of the Dutch polder areas. This slide shows some examples of typical building docks. Apart from caissons for closure works, the same approach is also used for the construction of tunnel elements, for immersed tunnels. This slide shows the interior of such a dock, just at the start of the construction works. The bed is prepared in such a way that the water can easily flow under the future caissons. Therefore, at the right places, first a gravel bed is made, on top of which the concrete will be poured. At the site, also some preparation has to be done. The bed has to be prepared, it should be on a desired level and it should be smooth. A challenge is to keep it that way. After leveling the sill, no serious bed movement is allowed anymore. So no accretion and no siltation. This means that the time between preparing the bed and placing the caissons should not be too long. After placement of the caissons, sometimes some extra loading is done to keep the caisson in position. The bottom of the caisson has to be shaped in such a way that piping cannot occur. To compute the piping risks, the formulas of Bly and Lane can be used. Bringing the caisson to location and sinking it requires also some stability analysis. A caisson is a lousy ship and not very stable in wave conditions. To prevent capsizing, the meter center, M, should be well above the center of gravity. Usually an empty box has a negative megacenter height, as shown in this example. In such a case, it may be needed to bring in some ballast to stabilize the caisson during sailing. Of course, ballast in the form of water is the most easy way, because it can easily be pumped in and out when lifting of the caisson is needed. However, when a water-filled caisson is tilting, all the water runs to one side and increases the load at that side. This may lower the meter center again and the caisson may capsize. Because of that, sometimes stabilizing bulkheads are built into the caisson to prevent that all the water can run to one side. For the placement of the last caisson, some extra space is needed. Therefore, always a final gap is needed, which is somewhat wider than the size of the caisson. Usually the remaining gap is filled with rock. To prevent the erosion of the rock from this gap, often steel nets are applied.